One, regarding some discrepancies which are still left out in electoral roll. Number two, photo voter slip distribution should be on time so that there is no scope for confusion in the mind of voters. They brought to Commission's attention about the distance of certain polling booths in left-wing affected areas. After shifting, the distance has gone up by 2-3 kilometers. Requested to make arrangements for ambulance, drinking water, first aid kits, etc. at the polling station. Requested to remove a look-alike election symbol from free symbol list, which has already been allotted to our state party. Some parties demanded that voter education program be strengthened to increase voter turnout in urban areas and remove urban apathy, because they were feeling concerned that in urban centers, the polling percentage remains low. Political parties demanded a strict implementation of model code of conduct in the state and demanded equitable treatment for all parties on MCC-related issues, on giving permissions, etc. Some parties complained about partisan attitude of some officials and requested the Commission to take action against those responsible for any partisan action. Some parties specifically complained about certain police officials for partisan behavior. One party complained about not getting a reply on the complaint submitted earlier. Some parties complained that some nominations were rejected or not accepted by returning officers, citing various reasons. One party complained that its nominee is in one constituency was pressurized to withdraw his nomination. Some parties complained about meetings based on religion and caste, and also brought to the notice of the Commission instance of making appeals based on caste and religion. Some political parties complained that in order to influence the election, a government order was issued and then kept in abeyance for implementation after election was over. Some parties again raised the issue of telephone tapping. Some parties alleged that she teams created by state governments are indulging in canvassing in favor of ruling party. Some parties complained about a book written by some authors and a constitutional authority having participated in its release function. Some parties alleged that ambulances are being used in parties' processions. One party requested that program of ministers be made available to chief electoral officer so that he can or his machinery can monitor that no officials are participating in these campaign tour programs. Some parties complained about announcement by a minister about saris distribution schedule. Political parties complained about distribution of money and liquor on a large scale and demanded to take effective action. Whereas some parties commended the efforts of the Election Commission machinery at seizing the record level of cash during the last 1 month, whereas elections are still 2 weeks away and they were hopeful that more efforts in this direction will yield rich dividends. One party complained that some political party candidates are spending much more than expenditure limit prescribed by the Election Commission, and these influential candidates are also trying to pressurize, allure candidates to withdraw their nominations. Some parties complained about distribution of bond paper by a candidate and distribution of money by police in some areas. Some political parties suggested installation of CCTV at sensitive locations as well as outside the polling station, because they apprehend that even outside the polling station, some pressurizing does take place. Some parties complained about high rates of various articles, services in Hyderabad, JHMC area, and raised the issue related to difference of advertisement rates between Director Information Public Relations and DABP, because they have to publish their criminal antecedents, and that is creating problems about payment and rates. Some parties pointed out in some districts, Suvidha, the single window system for granting permission for public meetings, etc., rallies, vehicles, is not functioning smoothly. About law and order, some parties wanted that effective preventive action should be taken in certain areas where it has not been taken yet. Some political parties complained about prejudiced treatment by media in coverage of their candidate and party rallies. In fact, one of the parties was expressing total helplessness on this account. One political party alleged that money, mafia, and media are being used to adversely affect democratic process. Parties complain that some TV channels and newspapers are indulging in paid news practice and demanded that newspaper channels owned by political parties, candidates, indulging in furthering the prospects of their party candidate be treated as paid news, and some parties even demanded to ban party-owned papers, oblique channels. They also complained that some political party-owned channels and newspapers are indulging in maligning the opposition parties and opponents, and requested to take appropriate action in this context. Advertisement issued by Andhra Pradesh government in Telangana, with ruling party there participating in elections, was objected to by some parties. Some parties raised the issues related to social media. Keeping in view all these concerns of political parties, Election Commission gave necessary directions for corrective measures to all the districts the last 1 month, whereas elections are still 2 weeks away, and they were hopeful that more efforts in this direction will yield rich dividends. One party complained that some political party candidates are spending much more than expenditure limit prescribed by the Election Commission, and these influential candidates are also trying to pressurize, allure candidates to withdraw their nominations. Some parties complained about distribution of bond paper by a candidate and distribution of money by police in some areas. Some political parties suggested installation of CCTV at sensitive locations as well as outside the polling station, because they apprehend that even outside the polling station, some pressurizing does take place. Some parties complained about high rates of various articles, services in Hyderabad, JHMC area, and raised the issue related to difference of advertisement rates between Director Information Public Relations and DABP, because they have to publish their criminal antecedents, and that is creating problems about payment and rates. Some parties pointed out in some districts, Suvidha, the single window system for granting permission for public meetings, etc., rallies, vehicles, is not functioning smoothly. About law and order, some parties wanted that effective preventive action should be taken in certain areas where it has not been taken yet. Some political parties complained about prejudiced treatment by media in coverage of their candidate and party rallies. In fact, one of the parties was expressing total helplessness on this account. One political party alleged that money, mafia, and media are being used to adversely affect democratic process. Parties complained that some TV channels and newspapers are indulging in paid news practice and demanded that newspaper channels owned by political parties, candidates, indulging in furthering the prospects of their party candidate be treated as paid news, and some parties even demanded to ban party-owned papers, oblique channels. They also complained that some political party-owned channels and newspapers are indulging in maligning the opposition parties and opponents, and requested to take appropriate action in this context. Advertisement issued by Andhra Pradesh government in Telangana with ruling party there participating in elections was objected to by some parties. Some parties raised the issues related to social media. Keeping in view all these concerns of political parties, Election Commission gave necessary directions for corrective measures to all the district election officers, all the superintendent of police, and also advised the state authorities, enforcement nodal agencies to keep in mind all these concerns of the main stakeholders of every election, that is political parties, and take care of their concerns effectively. Commission also directed the state election machinery to ensure effective monitoring and vigilance at all levels to address these concerns. Commission further directed that entire electoral process must be conducted in a free, fair manner. Steps must be taken to ensure that every elector is able to exercise his or her franchise without any threat, intimidation or inducement. This year's theme declared by Commission is accessible election, and therefore Commission also directed that all facilitation measures must be in place to facilitate persons with disabilities to come out and vote without any inconvenience. Commission gave again strict directions that model code of conduct must be enforced strictly and every complaint in this regard must be acted upon most promptly. Commission directed to ensure that permissions be granted through Suvidha single window system in equitable manner, because time and date stamping is there when the application was submitted. In that sequence, permissions must be granted and within the time limit prescribed by the Commission. Media certification and monitoring committees must be on high alert and take effective action against every paid news case. Commission further directed that as per the existing instructions, channels owned by political parties and candidates must also be subjected to this mechanism. So far, there have been 211 paid news cases during this campaign period, as against total number of cases detected in 2014, simultaneous election for Lok Sabha and Assembly, 358. There are certain important points which I would like to share with you. Since theme of this year is accessible elections, we have deployed accessibility observers who will be coming shortly to assess that all measures to facilitate persons with disabilities are in place. In fact, I am pleased to see that all districts are making arrangements even to transport persons with disabilities if they register for that kind of assistance so that they can vote without even walking. Commission directed to establish all women managed polling booths, which will be managed by women polling officials and women security officials. And at least 119 such polling booths will be in place. As per the direction of the Supreme Court, the Commission has already issued modified format of affidavit to be filed by candidates and political parties about their criminal antecedents, and also issued question and answer in this FAQs, frequently asked questions. Criminal antecedents shall be publicized in the specified format in at least 3 newspapers and 3 electronic media channels. In order to keep a close watch on the violation of model code of conduct and other violations in the state assembly elections, Election Commission has launched citizen vigilance, C-Vigil application, which has really done very good in Telangana, as the district election officials informed the commission that large number of complaints are received, out of which large number were verified to be true, and action has been initiated in most of those cases and the complainant informed. All polling stations of 119 assembly constituencies, that is total number of polling stations will be 32,574 and 222 auxiliary polling stations. So in all, 32,796 polling stations will be there. And average number of electors per polling station will be 856. All polling stations will be having electronic voting machine and voter verifiable paper audit trail, VVPAT machine. This time 100% polling stations will be covered by VVPAT machine. This machine is a printer where whatever button the elector presses, the same symbol, candidate's name, everything comes in the window of the VVPAT for 7 seconds. You can see that your vote is going to the same symbol, same candidate where you have pressed the button. And this slip gets cut and drops down in the box kept below. And Commission have made arrangement that one randomly selected polling station in each and every legislative assembly, the VVPAT slips will be mandatorily be counted and the result will be matched with the electronic count of control unit. Another arrangement is under Rule 56D. That is that in case a candidate or his or her polling agent or counting agent complains to the returning officer that there was something wrong on these polling stations and therefore the VVPAT slip should be counted. Returning officer has full powers to decide on such complaint and order by means of a speaking order that VVPAT slip of those polling stations shall also be counted or shall not be counted depending on the facts of the case. So there also arrangement will be made for counting the VVPAT slip on the complaints of the candidates or their counting agent. Commission directed that all personnel who go on polling duty, including the drivers of those buses which are acquired for transporting the CAPF and other polling officials, should be provided with a postal ballot. State police force personnel should also be provided with postal ballot, and it should be ensured that all of them get opportunity to cast their vote. Then there is electronically transmitted postal ballot system for service voters, Army, Navy, Air Force, and all those officials who are posted in our embassies abroad, high commissions abroad. These people are entitled for electronically transmitted postal ballot. This ballot will go either today or tomorrow from the returning officer to the concerned record office of that voter. They will have nearly 17-18 days to download it, to print it, to cast their vote, to put these vote ballots in the envelope and send it. And these envelopes will come by speed post to the returning officer. And all those ballots received before 11th December will be counted. And I'm very happy to note that in Telangana, last election, there were only 7,057 service voters. Whereas now this number has gone up to 10,038, almost 30% more. It is also very encouraging that Telangana is showing the way to all other states. All polling stations have 100% facility of ramp, drinking water, toilets, electricity, and waiting room or shade. That is commendable because everywhere, wherever commission goes, we find that some gaps are there. But here, all polling stations have 100% such voter facilitation services. Regarding law and order, Commission reviewed the law and order and directed the state administration and police to take further steps to tone up the security and law and order, take adequate preventive steps including execution of non-valuable warrants and bounding down of troublemongers. Another feature which is unique to Telangana, we found that a number of cases where people were bound over, troublemongers were bound over, and they violated that. They have been bound down, either sent to jail, or their security has been forfeited by the concerned authorities. Surprise inspections of jails will be conducted to check whether any mafia in the comforts of the jail is not leading operations in the Paul arena through his or her goons. Commission directed that effective monitoring be done through webcasting, micro observers, videography in all sensitive polling stations to ensure free and fair polling. Expenditure monitoring. Excellent results have been seen by the commission in this aspect in Telangana. Although the political parties have been saying that though good work has been done, but this may be tip of the iceberg and lot more needs to be done. They say that money, token, gifts, liquor, all these things are being distributed indiscriminately and through various innovative means. Whereas our machinery has already seized 77.80 crores. Whereas in 2014, whole election period, total seizure was 76 crores. We have exceeded that and still 2 weeks more are there. So that really corroborates the concern of the political parties, and therefore commission has directed the enforcement agencies to put the pressure up and ensure that more action is taken in this direction. IT initiatives of the commission, Suvidha, Samadhan, Sugam, etc. are being used here, and all the grievances of every citizen, every political party and candidate are being addressed within 24 hours. Permissions are given within 24 hours. Then under SWEEP, Systematic Voter Education and Electoral Participation Program, campaign is going on a large scale, and Telangana has done wonderfully well in this regard. In fact, commission also launched one or two CDs and other applications. Finally, commission is committed to maintain purity of elections and to deliver free, fair and transparent elections in Telangana as well as other poll going states. Commission has directed the state level and district level election machinery to be fearless, unbiased, neutral and independent from any influence whatsoever. Commission treats media as its friend, and therefore commission solicits proactive support of all stakeholders, that is political parties, media organizations, civil society, youth and community organizations, and all voters of Telangana to join hands with the commission and wholeheartedly participate in the polling on 7th December 2018 and deliver a free, fair and credible election to Telangana state and strengthen democracy in the country. Thank you.
We can take questions.
Commission has sought the facts so that commission can make up its mind and further initiate action. It's zero. Number of duplicates found is yes, there. Because you know, when electoral roll was in paper, none of us had the wherewithal to find out as to how many duplicates are there, because turning pages you can't find. Commission took steps to digitize the electoral roll, to use deduplication software, to identify duplicate names so that we can verify, and then we can ask the person concerned whether you want to get registered here or remain there, so that we can delete your name from elsewhere. So basically it is removal of duplicates and correction of errors, wherever errors are there, like epic number is same somewhere, whereas the person is different. So identifying these errors through technology and then correcting them. All these operations are being done. This process in 2015, and nearly 30 crore voters epic was seeded with Aadhaar when the Supreme Court's order for a stay came, and therefore commission also decided to stop that seeding. Right now there is one petition with the Supreme Court lying on this issue. This is J.R. Thakur versus Union and Election Commission and all. This has to be decided, but commission is still taking steps in consultation with UIADAI for formulating some means so that we can move ahead in this direction. And whatever concerns are from media, from other common voters, we can address those.
Sir, this is
our ruling is that such promises made in the manifesto should be objectively checked by the commission. And if there is no mention of how the resources will be mobilized for that kind of promise that is not stated, make them state that or initiate action. Orally saying something somewhere, that is not covered under this because it should be part of the manifesto, only then it comes under our purview.
Sir, I'm Bilal from Siyasat Daily, sir.
Permitted during election process, but now it is frozen till the poll. The process will again be taken up under summary revision with reference to 1119, and that purified electoral roll will be available for Lok Sabha election.
Sir.
Complaint against any party with specific details is immediately taken up for action by the Election Commission, and two or three complaints with specific details came yesterday in the night to us against the party concerned, you have said, and Commission immediately called for the records, called for the facts, and is in the process of completing that inquiry, and within one or two days, the results will be seen.
Better.
Hindi mein hi dunga. Koi is tarah ka empirical study karke tulna karna ki pichli baar kitna percent tha, abhi kitna percent hai, ye bahut mushkil hai. ये बिल्कुल एक्यूरेसी के साथ नहीं किया जा सकता, लेकिन मैं ये कह सकता हूँ कि पिछली रिव्यू में जो स्थिति थी और जितना कमीशन को चिंता थी वो खत्म हो गई, और कमीशन को काफ़ी कुछ संतोष हुआ है कि एक महीने में सीईओ और सारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स के डीओ और एसपीज ने बहुत मेहनत की है, काफ़ी ऊपर तक लाए हैं तैयारी को, और उम्मीद की जानी चाहिए कि जो निर्देश इस बार की मीटिंग में कमीशन ने उन्हें दिए हैं उनका भी क्रियान्वयन वो अगले एक हफ्ते में करके इस बार की पोलिंग जो 7 दिसंबर को होने वाली है उसे बहुत अच्छा करने में सफल होंगे.
सर,
कम्स टू द कमीशन अबाउट यूज ऑफ अब्यूजिव लैंग्वेज, यूज ऑफ प्रोवोकेटिव लैंग्वेज, इंसाइटिंग कम्युनल फीलिंग्स, कमीशन कम्स डाउन वेरी हैवीली in respect of such people or such parties. As and when such complaints reach us, we will definitely come down heavily, and in the past elections we in fact ordered that the topmost functionary of that party will now not campaign.
Sir, this is
like defacement, flag at wrongs or without permission, inducements, etc. So there are different categories, and that kind of classification you will get from the CEO in his press conference. But as compared to other states, commission found that there was more use by the citizens here, and in fact in one of the district which got 550 complaints, that is a record in fact. So it was quite satisfying that it is doing very well.
Sir, this is Venkat from Raj News. Sir, sir, this is Venkat from Raj News.
But this complaint came rather late in the day because pink ballot for all assembly elections started in 1952, and something which is laid down in 1952 cannot be changed because some party has adopted that color. So the objection should have been raised at the time of that party adopting that color, not us who are using this color since 1952.
Sir,
what can be done?
These journalists
would like to do this because this is very important. You are doing yeoman service for the social cause, cause of democracy, cause of election commission, cause of free and fair election. So you like to do this, but we will have to keep in mind also that you are working for some commercial concern also, and therefore we will have to insulate you from those commercial vested interests. Different scale. Here they are trying to provide help to all those who want. So it is a different scale. About persons with disability getting transport, about EVM, I am not aware that Mr. Lingdo or Mr. Sampath or anybody has said that it is not 100% tamper proof. anybody saying that with certain conditions that any machine in this world is not tamper proof, because machine doesn't have eyes, ears, mouth, hand. It can't protect itself. It has to be in the custody of some human being. And if that human being doesn't have any character, what happens to the machine, you can easily guess. That is something very different. But otherwise, these machines are totally tamper-proof. In the security regime which Election Commission prescribes, nothing can be done to these machines. And I mentioned, and the commission will examine legally and otherwise from MCC angle, what can be done in this regard. We will be seized of this matter. So thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
तो ये पॉलिटिक्स